What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel, and I want to share a tip with you today. Maybe blatantly obvious, but it took me a long time to figure it out, and that's how I'm going to engrave these leatherette patches. I do a bunch of these, and I used to engrave them, and then they would have the black soot all over the patch, and I would have to clean each individual patch, and it was just a nightmare. I mean, it was just a terrible situation. So I want to teach you something today. Maybe you don't know. Maybe it will help you in the future. About a way easier way to do this. Now, I've been buying my leatherette from JDS. They have the self-adhesive kind. And some of you have probably seen the video I made where I was putting adhesive on the back of leatherette from JDS. I've gone to buying theirs, and this is why. It does cost a little more, but the adhesive that they use is sticky. So if you're applying it yourself to the hat, when you go to stick it on the hat, it's already sticky and you don't have to put any heat tape on the patch to hold it in place. Sometimes when you go to take that heat tape off, it'll leave like little funny spots on your leatherette. So I'd much rather use the adhesive kind and just be able to stick it on, press, boom, and move on. So let me show you a little tip about how I keep it from having to clean all of these patches individually, and I'll show you right now. All right, over at the laser. So what I'm going to do is put my leather right down to make sure it's pretty square. And then I'm going to tape it. I'm going to go up on the leather at about a quarter of an inch. So you do lose a little bit of leather at. Now I'm going to push the leather out with my hand and then lay a magnet right here so that I don't have any wrinkles on that side. I want it to be down tight. All the way around. So I want to make sure it's down pretty good, so that, because I'm going to be wiping on that thing pretty hard. Also, as a side note, on this Eon, this honeycomb will move. I know on some of the other lasers they won't, but this will move. So I've actually put that little focus tool and jammed it in there so that my honeycomb does not move. It's very important that doesn't move. All right. So now that I've got the file all set up and my cut and my fills, I'm going to go up and I'm going to turn off the line. And then I'm going to send just the fill. Damn. Alright. Well, once the fill's gone, I'm going to turn the fill off. I'm going to turn the line on. And I'm going to send just the cut line. I'm going to mark that line. You can call them whatever you want. I just want to know the difference when I'm at the laser. It's going to show me on the screen, so I don't know. So that's it. We send it in two separate files. Now, once the patches are engraved, I'm going to get a lot of LA Awesome on a paper towel. It's got to be quite a bit because you're going to see all that stuff that's coming off of there? And you're just going to wipe them. And you need to wipe them really well. Because the last thing you want to do is have to clean them individual patches. Keep getting fresh paper towels. If you've got it taped down good and you've got that honeycomb wedged in there, it's not going anywhere. You don't have to be afraid. See, I'm still getting a little, but not much. Go ahead and go back over it again with a fresh batch of LA Awesome. some fresh paper towels. It's good to use a lint-free. I normally use shirts for this. You can give it a final wipe with a shirt if you want. Just to make sure you don't get any lint, paper towel in your black stuff. Just give it a rub with your hand, maybe. Now, once that's clean, I'm going to go back in and find my line file. I'm going to hit start. And that's just going to cut them all out, and I will not have to clean them when I'm done. I hope this makes your hatch jobs a little easier. See you guys next time.